Welcome back to the Red Cat Habitat. Today we are going to be looking at a couple of movies created by world-renowned director Ridley Scott.
What is your name?
Now, Ridley Scott has made two movies prequeling his original masterpiece, Alien. And those are Prometheus and Covenant.
Fire.
In said movies, Scott explores a lot of really interesting themes, very thought-provoking stuff.
How do you feel? Alive. What do you see? Fight.
Ideas I thought we could explore just a little today.
We are the gods now.
Prometheus and Covenant are the first two movies in a prequel trilogy to the movie Alien from 1979, directed by the visionary Ridley Scott. These two films, being that close to something that is beloved and in our pop culture and very nostalgic, have, like many other similar works, been subject to a perhaps higher degree of criticism. I'm a fan of both movies, and I recently came across a fan edit in which the gentleman responsible for said edit has taken both movies and combined them into one.
I am your father.
He goes by the handle of Job Willens. He's active on social media, and you can find his work with relative ease via your favorite search engine. He's titled his edit Paradise, which I think is particularly fitting considering the allusions of Prometheus and Covenant. Important to note also is that the editing project here was made for educational and private nonprofit use. It's not an official product. It does not represent the original filmmaker's intent. Another thing I want to make a note of while I'm at it is that if you notice any glitching in the video right here on my review, just know that that is all on my end. Job Willens' cut is pristine, to say the least. It's gorgeous. It's kind of amazing how well these two separate bodies of work, Prometheus and Covenant, really gel when they are brought together by somebody who knows what they're doing.
Dr. Shaw, how did she end up here?
Now, I put those two titles in just to demonstrate the fluidity of his cuts. Early on in the movie, he uses some of his own titles in between scenes to kind of introduce where the two storylines are separated. But as the cut goes on and the viewer becomes more familiar with the subject matter and the separate casts from each story, those visual aids pull back and it relies on the viewer and their familiarity with the subject to infer when the two storylines are separated. And for me, it wasn't a problem. It was done elegantly, and if you're not looking for that sort of thing, you might not even notice. In this cut, this edit, I believe that it's a great success, to the point where I think that seeing these movies presented in this way really helps to complement what it was that the filmmakers were trying to do. Fleshes out a lot of the characters, it brings to light some of the themes that, if you watch the movie separately, although enjoyable and all the messages are still there, I think watching it like this, for me anyway, really helped me to identify what it was, I think, that Ridley Scott and his team were trying to tell us.
We can create cybernetic individuals who, in just a few short years, will be completely indistinguishable from us. Which leads to an obvious conclusion. We are the gods now.
Although at first it might take a moment or two to keep in mind that you're watching two separate timelines or points on that one timeline,
after a little while, you get used to it, and it is intriguing to see what happens. These stories are separated by, I think, about 10 years. And it's kind of fascinating to, right after watching one scene, see what happens later on and then jump back. And it tells the story in such a way that it really keeps you glued to the screen. The runtime is a little longer than the average movie, obviously, but it's not as long as if you were to sit down and watch both original cuts.
What is your name?
This cut does exclude, obviously, certain scenes that were in both of the originals, but it also includes some stuff that was cut, which when I watch it in this edit, I think it's integral, and it just makes a lot of sense to see those parts brought back in.
Plus, there was a sun, but it had no one to shine on. So the sun made man, and man looked up at the sun and asked, "Why did you make me?" And the sun said, "Because I was alone. My whole life I've been looking for what we found today."
There's a lot of nuance to the edit of Paradise. It's clear that this was a labor of love, and that Willens is a fan of these movies. Paradise takes Prometheus and Covenant, two great movies created by masters, and weaves them together with skill and shows incredible pacing by putting them together in just the right way. I can honestly say that this work is as complementary to the original pieces as it is transformative. If you haven't seen both of the originals, go out and give them a shot. And even if you have, take another look. You never know what you might find.
Secure.
Copy that.
On that note, you've been listening to Red Cat Habitat. This has been a review of the movies Prometheus, Covenant, and the fan edit Paradise.
Wasn't my idea.
If you've enjoyed what you've heard, please give us a like or a share. And if you like what you've seen, please give these movies a watch. And if you want to find Paradise, the Job Willens fan cut, just go ahead and look up his Tumblr or put the information in the description. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a marvelous day. Go out and enjoy this beautiful world. Thanks.
From up here, Ferris. It's a good thing you're driving and not the old man.
Hey, a little less of the old man, sweet tits.
Hey, language. Be respectful there, sugar dick.
I can hear you.
She started it.